We are invited to a feast today. We gather around the table of the Lord, summoned by the Holy Spirit, to share in this Eucharistic meal with family, friends, and neighbors, fellow pilgrims on the journey. May this feast nourish and sustain us as we go forth in joy to continue building the kingdom in our little corner of the world and beyond. There will be a second collection today for the annual appeal. Because of the pandemic, we were unable to have the regular annual appeal in March, so this special collection will go toward meeting our goal. Please be generous and place your offerings in the basket in the lobby. Thank you. Please rise to greet our celebrant, Father Steve, and join in singing our opening hymn number 414 in your Breaking Bread hymnals, All Are Welcome, number 414.
Welcome to Our Lady of Good Counsel as we celebrate the 28th Sunday of Ordinary Time. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to receive the gift of our Lord. Lord Jesus, you guide us along the paths. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you show us the way to the banquet of eternal life. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have
mercy. Lord Jesus, you fully supply what we need. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O Lord, may your grace at all times go before us and follow after us, and make us always determined to carry out good works. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines, juicy, rich food and pure, choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord will wipe away the tears from every face. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, I know how to live in humble circumstances. I know also how to live with abundance. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance and of being in need. I can do all things in him who strengthens me. Still, it was kind of you to share in my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accord with his glorious riches in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father, glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. According to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus again, in reply, spoke to the chief priests and the elders of the people in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the invited guests to the feast. They refused to come. A second time he sent other servants, saying, 'Tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and my fattened cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come to the feast.' Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy to come. Go out therefore into the main roads and invite to the feast whomever you find.' The servants went out into the streets and gathered all they found, bad, good, and alike. And gathered all they found to the hall where it was filled with guests. And when the king came in to meet the guest, he saw a man there not dressed in a wedding garment. The king said to him, 'My friend, how is it that you came in here without a wedding garment?' But he was reduced to silence. Then the king said to his attendants, 'Bind his hands and feet, and cast him into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth.' Many are invited, but few are chosen." The Gospel of the Lord. All that's been going on, so many of us have missed out on so many wonderful things with our families and friends. We haven't been to a good banquet or feast. Weddings have been postponed or shortened to just a few. And yet our readings tonight are filled with the images of joyful banquets, of joyful feasts. Isaiah the prophet describes the rich feast of food and choice wines, juicy, rich food and pure choice wines on the mountain. And he's telling everyone who follows God's ways that you are invited to share in this feast. Jesus tells the parable of the great feast prepared by the king for his son's wedding, and all the great things he has prepared, and how so many fail to come to it. But you and I have been invited to the greatest of all feasts, the heavenly feasting that Jesus has prepared for us, the banquet of life in heaven. We receive that invitation. It was marked on our whole hearts and our souls in our baptism. We were called to follow the way of Jesus. He wrote in our hearts his love and wants us to follow him. And as long as we follow him, our place at that heavenly banquet is assured. He wants us to be able to share his gifts. Of course, the prophet Isaiah also talks about the price that will come for that redemption that the Messiah would be bringing, that would open the doors to that great feast, that banquet in heaven. Of course, we know he was talking about the mountain, the hill called Golgotha, where Jesus would offer himself up so that he could open the gates to eternal life and to the banquet of heaven for each of his followers. In the gospel, Jesus is talking to the people, the chief priests, the elders, the Pharisees, all the people, leaders of the religious community of the Israelites, about what God had prepared for them. And of course, he was talking about the servants that were sent out as the prophets, who came out and warned and kept telling the people that God had not abandoned them, that he would send one into the world to redeem them and open the way to eternal life. And of course, that one would be his son, Jesus. But he's telling those people, those leaders, they failed to listen. They failed to live what they had professed in their faith, which was preparation for the coming of the Messiah. And so he's telling them now, you rejected the prophets. Many of the prophets were killed, as well as just beaten and scorned. And even John the Baptist, the last of the great prophets of the Old Testament, the first great prophet of the New Testament, they didn't listen to him, and that he was killed for proclaiming the presence of the Messiah. And so he's telling them now that this gift of eternal life is going to be offered to new people. And of course, the new people would be everyone. That's the imagery of the story of sending out his servants to the main streets, or the byways and highways, as it used to say. We old people like those old sayings much better. But anyway, he was saying that all are being invited and to come into the feast because Jesus himself was making them worthy of receiving that gift. And then the little story at the very end about the one fella who was invited in and didn't put on a wedding garment. You know, at the time of Jesus, you couldn't rent a tux or anything like that. But everyone was expected to dress in a nice way. And it was part of the responsibility of the host of the feast, if someone didn't have a proper attire, to provide them with a wedding garment, usually a white tunic or a brown tunic that would fit in. So when he asked the man why he wasn't wearing the proper garment, it wasn't because he didn't have the money or because it wasn't available. He chose not to. That's why he's silent when the king says, "Why aren't you dressed properly?" And then he throws him out. That's Jesus giving us a warning that while we have been chosen, while we have received the invitation, while he has written in our hearts the invitation to the heavenly banquet, we have to follow and live his way. We have to dress ourselves in Christ. That's why we receive that white garment in baptism. It signifies the new life of Christ that we put on. And here's the wonderful news of all this. Jesus has told us, so long as we try, so long as we make the effort to follow his way, even if we fail, so long as we turn back to him and ask his forgiveness, our way to the eternal banquet is set for us. So let us be filled with the joy of knowing that there's a place waiting for each one of us at the heavenly table. And all we have to do is try to follow in the footsteps of Jesus. Try to live our lives responsibly. Try to live our lives as Christians. Try to present his message to others. And most of all, to accept and love one another as Jesus has loved us.
Let us join together in professing our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us raise our prayers up to God, whom we trust to fully supply whatever we need.
Our response is, Lord, hear us. For the church, that we may always welcome all who approach with sincere hearts and be a model of acceptance and hospitality to all who seek refuge. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For all who feel unaccepted and unworthy due to their circumstances, hardships, or identity, that they may always realize God's inclusive invitation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For a growing respect in society for all human life, from conception to natural death, from the main road to the dingy alleys, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For Indigenous people around the globe, especially those who have suffered generations of rejection or mistreatment, that they may be treated with respect and dignity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
Restore all the sick, especially Peter Killinger, to health and wholeness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
May those who have gone before us, Julia Stanek, Monsignor Thomas Ivory, Monsignor Joseph Ambrosio, Clyde Jerome Parker, Francis Madura Agmagnac, and John Bobby Keane, enjoy eternal life at the banquet table of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
For those for whom this Mass is offered, Mary Renard, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us. Generous God, you shower everyone with your great generosity, bad and good alike, rich and poor alike, strong and weak alike. Grant us the grace to do the same, as you hear the prayers we make today and every day, through your greatest gift of all, your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Please join in singing our presentation hymn number 695 and your Breaking Bread hymnals, Hail Mary, Gentle Woman, number 695.
Thank you.
say, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, accept the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the
Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know that it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exulting praise as we sing. Rightly gives you praise. Through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of your saving passion, his wondrous resurrection, and his ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, We offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and are filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, and the Order of Bishops, and all the clergy and entire people your Son has gained for you. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We ask our Father to give us our daily bread here, so that we may share the bread of life with him in heaven forever. And so we can say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed coming of your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of our Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And let's exchange with each other a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in singing our communion hymn number 326 in your breaking bread, Ubi Caritas, number 326.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O Lord, we entreat your majesty most humbly that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so make us sharers of his divine nature, for he lives and reigns forever and ever.
There are three brief announcements. There will be a second collection next weekend, October 17th and 18th, for World Mission Sunday. It is also our monthly collection for the Parish Needs Fund. Please be generous to both of these and place your donations in the baskets in the lobby. Monday is Columbus Day. There will be no 7:30 a.m. Masses on Monday and Tuesday of this week. On Tuesday, October 13th, Cardinal Tobin and priests from around New Jersey will lead a Rosary for Life conference call. The goal is 1,000 people praying. Cards with the contact information will be available at the doors after Mass.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and serve the Lord by loving and serving each other.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, number 205, in your breaking bread, Hail Holy Queen, number 205.
Have a lovely week, everyone.